Soviet Union continues to expand in both military might and political influence.
Soviet Russia holds a commanding position in the future destiny of the world.
But it was the United States that held the secret to atomic power.
The flags of freedom fly all over the world.
This superiority would be short-lived, however, as Stalin was already at work on a plan of his own. While searching for uranium on a tiny island off the southeast coast of the Soviet Union, Russian engineers discovered E-99, a powerful and unprecedented source of energy. Seeing an opportunity for further world domination, Stalin authorizes unlimited development funds to explore the capacities of the substance. Project director Viktor Barisov establishes an island research station, Katorga 12. For his groundbreaking research, he receives the Order of Lenin. When Nikita Khrushchev succeeds Stalin, he accelerates the program, pressuring Barisov to begin field experiments. However, not only is E-99 capable of delivering unimagined power, it is also incredibly volatile. Yet Barisov is pressured to begin tests. Disaster has no known survivors. Moscow buries the installation, effectively wiping it from the map. 2010, a US spy satellite flying over the area is blinded by a radiation surge. Fearing another Chernobyl, and suspicious of Moscow's secrecy, the reconnaissance mission over Katorga 12 is ordered by the Pentagon.
Must report to registration. All those who have previously registered are free to enter through the North Gate.
This is Devlin Forward. We're ahead, goddammit, I repeat. We're ahead.
Titan 1 Actual here. What's your status, Captain?
We got punched out. Copter's down and we're scattered. Don't know how many KIAs yet. Over.
Satellite's got you about 30 clicks south of a radio tower. Get your team there, Captain. We're pulling you out.
Understood, sir. Spartan team, if you copy, switch your comm gear to TAC 3. Meet up at the rally point.
The influx of new scientists and technicians to Katorga 12 has dwindled to nothing. Rumor has it that Dr. Borisov might become the new head of Katorga 12, but I doubt Moscow has much confidence in him. If only Dr. Demichev hadn't died in the fire.
Construction is completed. The tower will be home to the Borisov reactor. This powerful device will generate a singularity, an event horizon that will provide the Soviet Union with unlimited energy that is both clean and safe. You are here. The village area contains the civilian docks, where new personnel first arrive on Katorga 12. It is home to many of the inhabitants of the island, and features a school that offers the best in Russian education.
By some miracle, you're alive and hearing this. Rally at the base of the radio tower we passed over before we got bounced. SNR's running carpool from there. Double time it. Move!
Help! Help! For the love of God, please! Let me out! stop! Don't let them attack!
Influx of new scientists and technicians to Katorga 12 has increased tenfold since Dr. Demichev went to Moscow. His presentation of our work must have been very successful. Additional facilities are being built, and our research funds continue to grow. And to think, only 4 weeks ago, Dr. Demichev almost died in that fire. Whoever saved him did us all a huge favor. Completed in 1955, the tower serves as home to the Demichev reactor. This powerful device generates the Singularity, an event horizon that provides the Soviet Union with unlimited energy that is both clean and safe.
Time I have, so I'll make this quick. The Singularity exploded about 2 hours ago, killing hundreds of people. But spreading radiation is also having effects. It's mutating humans into violent monsters, and they feed on human flesh. I have to get out of here before they find me.
Titan 1 Actual, copy. For fuck's sake, someone copy back! Copy back and tell me things look a little south of normal, because I'm officially freaking out! I'm going Section 8 here. I know it, damn it. Okay, eyes forward. Keep to the original directive. Continue to the radio tower.
Anyone should find this recording, please. Our children are hiding in a room at the top of the stairs. They only have a limited amount of food and water and won't be able to last for much longer. Please, they're so scared.
Titan 1, if you're receiving, I'm in what looks like a school, and there's some guy... Holy mother!
Are to be alert at all times and remain aware of emergency testing procedures.
Explosion. Miss Barsukova screamed and ran out of the classroom. Dr. Demichev has told us the equipment they're installing at the school is safe, but I'm worried. I have a friend who works at one of the animal testing labs, and he told me E99 mutates living flesh. How could they expose the children to something like that?
Dr. E99. He's our answer to the growing menace of the United States. You see, America created the atomic bomb, a powerful weapon they've used twice now on large cities. But thanks to a recent discovery, we control something much more powerful. We control the might of E99. E99 is a rare element that can only be found deep underground here on Katorga 12. A base was built on this island to study it. You see, our scientists think that someday they will be able to use E99 to accomplish some pretty amazing things. Like taking barren farmland and making it productive again. Or taking a sick man and making him a super soldier. They even hope to be able to turn back the clock on old citizens and make them young again. The might of E99 means we no longer need to fear America's atomic power. The possibilities for E99 seem endless. Who knows? With its help, we may soon be able to travel through time itself. But whatever its uses, we can sleep soundly, knowing that E99 will protect us from the evils of the West and make the Soviet Union a safe
front of us. We can't trade with anyone. Not that I feel like eating much. My stomach has been hurting a lot lately.
There has been another event. This one much worse than the last. It has exceeded Barisov's threshold. We are securing the facility, and then we will make our way down the hill. We must leave Katorga 12 at once.
Good to see you, Renko. If you hadn't come along, I'd be dead. All right, we're supposed to meet up with SNR yesterday. Let's move on.
What the hell were these things? Seen anything like them? Did the Russians create them? But if they did, why?
Now, I could have missed it, but I'm pretty sure a massive pillar of energy shooting into the sky wasn't mentioned in the mission briefing. This is Devlin 4-1. Do you copy, Titan 1? Titan 1, this is Devlin 4-1 on guard frequency. Please respond. Are we good to go with extraction?
Thank you.
Let's stick to the plan. Get to the radio tower. Maybe we can salvage equipment there if we need it. How could Intel have been so wrong? I mean, this place is anything but abandoned. Something's not right. We should at least be able to hear the Titan One broadcasting. Search and rescue teams better be on their friggin' way right now.
Responsibility. And of course, the most important thing to remember